From beautiful Fenway Park in Boston, Massachusetts, we've got baseball on the show. It's the Tampa Bay Rays and the Boston Red Sox. First pitch coming your way next.
And now, your Boston Red Sox.
So almost ready to get underway. And on the hill in this one, Michael Wacha. What do we need to know here?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Ready for action from Fenway Park. And stepping in for the Rays, Yandy Diaz.
The third baseman, number two.
And a pitch. Slice to right. And a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Here's Wander Franco. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Next offering is in for a strike.
Really good cutter that he's able to front door and back door. That pitch is devastating.
And a 1-1. On the ground, the third might be two. Goes to second for one. Over to first, safe.
That is good. The first baseman, G-Man.
And now the hitter, G-Man Choi. Move to first. Back standing. He's in there safely. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Pickoff move to first. Franco back on a dive. Back over to first. And he's back again. Left-hand hitter waits.
Quickly in an 0-2 hole, you're going to have to give something up here in terms of power if you want to put the ball in play with any authority.
The 0-2. Went too far that time. It's 1-2.
One ball, two strikes. Down.
That misses the zone. 2-2. Pitch and a foul ball. He stays alive. Swing and a miss, and he's down on strikes, and there's two away.
Typically that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Now it's Randy Arozarena. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Nice warm day here, good baseball weather. Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about, you know, getting jammed on fastballs inside part of the plate. You can kind of be more selective instead of just looking out away so that you can get the barrel to it in that part. You can get it on the inside part of the plate as well.
Oh. In the air, center field. Bradley moving back for this one. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. The Rays strand just the one. Now the Red Sox will get their shot. No score. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back here at Fenway, and our starting pitcher here today, Jalen Beeks. What should we keep an eye on here?
Well, he's a guy that needs to establish himself, just settle in that first time through the order, be able to command your first pitch, maybe a secondary pitch, and not show too much. That will allow you to get through the order a couple of times before having to turn it over to the bullpen in those middle innings. They're looking for this guy to get through the lineup a couple of times at least, limit some damage, and just keep him in this ballgame.
Back here in Boston, and stepping in for Boston, Franchy Cordero. And there's the strike. And now the lefty. And that one fouled off. Swings and misses at the breaking ball in the dirt. Beats him for the first out, and that completes the strikeout.
Batting second, the third baseman, Rafael Devers.
And here is Devers. In there, and it's 0-1. The 0-1. There's the strike. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And two away now. J.D. Martinez stands in.
The designated hitter, J.D. Martinez.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Pulls up and it drops for a hit.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
And here is Xander Bogaerts. The pitch. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. So that's two straight two out hits.
Back to back base hits. Nice line drive to the pull side. Netted out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
So two down. Here's Alex Verdugo. And fouled off. Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. Next offering is fouled back. The pitch. To third, Diaz picks it up on the run, throw to first, and that is the inning. Boston strands a pair, scoreless after one. Back here at Fenway as we go to the second, Harold Ramirez at the dish.
The designated hitter, Harold.
Yeah, the right hander back to work. And that one a little bit high. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, it looks like he's wanting to work the upper part of the strike zone. What does that mean? Top hand better be working for the hitters. Adjust that side a little bit. Give yourself a chance to hit.
Next pitch misses, and a count 2-1. That one in for a strike, 2-2. The next pitch misses, and the count's full. And the righty deals. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. And Vasquez able to pull it down.
Well, that's what he's looking for with the fastball above the zone. A swing and miss or weak contact.
The right fielder, number 15, Josh Lowe.
Josh Lowe now at the plate. That one's in there, 0-1. Second inning here, no score. Next offering is in for a strike.
He doesn't seem to like the pitch up, hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
And he deals. And it's fouled away. Here's the 0-2. That one missed. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Two gone now.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time,
the catcher,
a little anxious.
Francisco Mejia.
Francisco Mejia coming up to hit. And that's in there for strike one. Now the 0-1. He swings and fouls one off. No score here in the second. Look out. That fastball drilled him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
I thought they were getting out of the inning right there, but not so fast. Let's see what the offense can do now that they have a base runner.
Brett Phillips at the plate with two away. Swings through that one. Next offering is in for a strike. And look out. That one gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one.
I don't care what some players might say. Nobody likes getting hit by a pitch unless you're in an 0-2 count and there's a knuckleball right out there on the mound.
Now here is Taylor Walls. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Two on, two outs. Just off the outside edge.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
High fly ball out to center field. Bradley drifts towards it, brings it in, and that is that. So the Rays strand a pair. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. bottom of the second.
Here's the veteran second baseman, Trevor Story.
Leading off for the Red Sox, the second baseman, Trevor Story.
Beeks back to work. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1. Next pitch is outside. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and quickly one away in the second.
Tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out batting when they're on seven. The mound, because the if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it could take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence, and it's a multi-run home run.
Christian Vasquez, the hitter. Next pitch is popped up. Franco moving under it. Makes the grab, and there's two down.
Batting eight, the center fielder, Jackie Bradley.
Two outs, base is empty. So stepping in for Boston, Jackie Bradley Jr.
Boog, this guy's just a tremendously talented center fielder. Gold glove caliber type out there. Offensively, he can do some things, but you know, also has some streakiness as well. I think the key is just trying to find a way for him to be consistent day in and day out. You know, he saves runs in the outfield, so that's going to buy him more time to work things out at the dish. This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Bradley waits. Popped up left side. Franco makes the catch, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for Boston. We'll move to the third with no score. Back inside Fenway Park, onto the third inning. Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Yandy Diaz.
The third baseman, number two, Yandy Diaz.
Waka back to work. Misses outside, and it's 1-0. The wind of the pitch. And the 1-0 misses low.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
The pitch. Ground ball right side. Dahlbeck steps on the bag and one away in the top of the third.
Now batting Wander Franco.
Now batting Wander Franco. He's 0-1. That hits the dirt, and that's ball one. Top of the third, no score. Next offering is in for a strike.
1-1.
And a swing and a line drive at a right field. Cordero makes the play, and there are two down.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the first baseman, G-Man.
G-Man Choi, next to hit for the Rays. First pitch, and he just misses. And that one wrapped foul. So now 1-2. On the ground, Story collects it. Not in time, and he reaches safely.
Definitely a tough play right there, and he had a little trouble on the transfer. Didn't seem to be able to get the grip and get rid of it, and that made all the difference.
Randy Arozarena getting ready to hit. In there, and it's 0-1. The pitch. And ball one. And now two balls and a strike. Bounced out to short. It's through for a hit. So that's two straight two out hits. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
That's back-to-back singles for him. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock. And we'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Ramirez in the box now. Takes strike one. Two outs. Swings through that one.
Gosh, a little late on that breaking ball. I don't think he recognized it out of the hand. Just a little tardy. Gonna have to regroup here.
And the pitch. That one drifts inside. Righty delivers. And a ball evens the count. First and second, two down. And the right-hander deals. And now it's filled up. That's the third out.
A lot of adrenaline. We can see it right there. And sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Back here at Fenway, here's Bobby Dalbec.
Leading off for the Red Sox, the first baseman, Bobby Dalbec.
The wide to kick the pitch. And a foul ball. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. No balls, two strikes. That's inside. And a swing and a miss. One down. Now it's Franchy Cordero.
The right fielder, Franchy Cordero.
And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch is downstairs. Left-hand batter waits. Fly ball down the line. Dives and makes the catch.
Up next for the Red Sox.
This dive wasn't the result of a bad route, Singy. The only reason he made the play is because his route was so good.
No doubt, Boog. StatCast tells the same story. I mean, he got to his spot as quickly as you can possibly get there, and he had to in order to have a chance at that diving play. Just special.
Here's Rafael Devers. And the first offering is not close. Next offering is in for a strike.
He's done a great job getting the first two outs. Want to get this number two hitter, get back in the dugout, and face 3-4-5 next inning.
And a pitch. And Devers hits that one. A Rosarena settles under this one, makes the catch, and that's the inning. Down in order go the Red Sox. And we're still knotted at zero. Back here at Fenway Park, start of the fourth. Now it's the right fielder, Josh Lowe.
For Tampa Bay, the right fielder, number 15.
And the pitch.
Josh Lowe.
Right through there for a strike.
Hold one for count.
That's in there. 0-2 now.
Well, we call that key holding. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
A swing and a miss. Now one away.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching.
Francisco.
Get ahead in the count. Get the guy in the box on his heels and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
Francisco Mejia next to hit for the Rays. In there for strike one. One down, base is empty. Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone. He made him pay for that one, and they jump ahead in the fourth. It's 1-0.
That pitch was intended to stay inside, but it leaked out over the middle of the plate. Hitter waited on it, and he connected just perfectly.
Here's the center fielder, Brett Phillips.
Now batting, the center fielder.
Next pitch downstairs, ball one.
So, Boog, you went to college in this town. What was it like for you being a college student and having the opportunity to bounce over here to Fenway Park and see some games?
Yeah, in fact, 1990, a couple of college classmates and I, we were in college. We bought standing room tickets, and then the next night got a chance to see the Red Sox clinch the East against the White Sox in that sliding catch in the corner by Tom Brudansky. The Red Sox would end up losing to the Oakland A's in the playoffs, but that's one of the things that I'll think about in terms of memories from going to college and going to Fenway. And that one actually would be grabbed by Story, and there are two outs.
The batter number 6, second baseman, Taylor Walls.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Taylor Walls. And first offering is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's a ball.
I got one ball, one strike.
That misses the zone, and it's 2-1. Righty to the plate. Swing and a ball popped up. And that is the third out of the inning. The Rays kick off the score with a solo bomb. It's now 1-0. Back here in Boston, bottom four. Now it's the DH, J.D. Martinez.
The designated hitter.
Both you and I know how much attention to detail that J.D. Martinez pays. Kind of makes me think of Albert Pujols, who has been called the machine at times during his career. I'd venture to say you could put J.D. Martinez in that same category, at least the way he approaches his craft.
Next offering misses, ball two. Wind in the pitch. Swing and a miss. Now two balls and a strike for J.D. Martinez, his teammate when they won it all in 2018. Ian Kinsler called him the mad scientist. So maybe the machine and the mad scientist. And down on strikes he goes. And one gone in the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher are on the same page right now.
Shortstop, Xander Bogart.
And here comes Xander Bogarts. And he's already singled in this game. First offering misses the mark.
But I don't believe until J.D. Martinez arrived in Boston, they didn't videotape their batting practices, and something we're seeing more and more teams do now so that guys can have instant feedback before the game starts.
Next one is off the plate, and the count is 2-0. The 2-0 is in for a strike. Next offering down in the dirt.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
Home team down a run. The Rays leading on the solo homer. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2. Late swing, fouled off.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
3-2. Got him. Two away.
Well, he froze him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling when you think the ball's going to get into the gutter and somehow just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
Alex Verdugo up next for the Red Sox. And a foul ball. Next one in the dirt. Going to count one and two.
One and two.
Lined into right, and that's a base hit. And that means Trevor Story will have a chance to hit.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Here's Trevor Story. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. One left for the Red Sox. They still trail 1-0. Back now at Fenway. Top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton.
Leading off for Tampa
and
Bay,
leading it off, Yandy Diaz.
Number two, Yandy Diaz.
The pitch. And downstairs. Activity in the bullpen for the Red Sox. Number 60 up and loosening in the pen. Number 57 getting loose as well. And here it comes. And now 2-0. Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here. There's a strike.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable to play is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
Kicks and deals. Ground ball up the middle, and that one finds its way through. And the leadoff man aboard.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Wander Franco next to hit for the Rays. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. And first offering is fouled off. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. And that one in the air center field. And that's a base hit. Lead runner to second. So two on and nobody out.
Oh, that's two strike hitting right there. He did well just to put the ball in play. These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it.
Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move for the bullpen. Michael Wacha gives way, and he leaves in a one-run game. New pitcher coming up. We'll be back in a minute. Hirokazu Sawamura into the game, and his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Now at the plate, G-Man Choi. First and second here, no outs. Next offering is in for a strike.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation but maybe a long relief guy to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
At the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss. And one gone.
Just blown away in that at bat. Three fastballs, all strikes. He wasn't even able to foul one off. There's not much you can take away from an at bat like that as a hitter, other than maybe there's something wrong with your eyes. Got to have better timing on the fastball next time.
Here's a speed threat, Randy Arozarena. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Runners at first and second with one gone. Next pitch in the dirt, one and one. Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss. And that is strike two. Right-handed reliever. Pitch misses outside. Now two and two. One out. Runners at first and second. Stays alive. Inside, three and two the count. And a pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains three and two. The pitch. And they're all loaded up.
Oh, that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
And next is the designated hitter, Harold Ramirez. Struck out looking in his first at bat.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam. Tough situation right here. So important as a pitcher to get ahead in the count as he did right there.
The pitch.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
In the air, right field. Cordero has a beat on it. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. Out number two.
The white beauty, number 15, Josh.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Josh Lowe.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Swung on, popped up left side. Bogarts drifts towards it, makes the grab, and that's the inning. And the Rays leave him loaded, but they still lead it 1-0. Back in Boston, we head to the bottom of the fifth. So here's Christian Vasquez.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Ball one, no strike.
And now the lefty. That's towards center. Phillips in position, puts the squeeze on it, and there's one down.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Bradley.
And now the center fielder, Jackie Bradley Jr. Jackie Bradley Jr., there's some swing and miss, but he's got some pop as well.
The best example of a streaky hitter. When he gets hot, team can jump on his back because he will carry him for a while.
And he deals. Strike two. Next offering misses down and away. And a 1-2. Good eye right there. And it's filled up. And there's ball four.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches. And somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Dahlbeck in the box now, takes strike one. And the 0-1 in there at the knees for a strike.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Next pitch just misses. It's a ball and two strikes. Next offering is down low. The 2-2 now. On the ground, two ball. To Franco for one. Oh, the throw is over his head.
Well, no trouble getting the double play started, but clearly some trouble on that return throw to first. I'm not sure if the runner going into second had a part in that or if it was something like a bad transfer. Either way, could have been two outs, but instead, they got to work around a runner in scoring position now.
Franchi Cordero up next for the Red Sox. And that's in there for strike one. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
And here's a slow roller down the line, and it's foul. So the tying run at second. And now one and two. Foul ball, he stays alive. Runner at second, two down. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Diaz makes the play, and that is the inning. And the Red Sox leave one. They're down 1-0. Set for the top of the sixth. And now the catcher for the Rays, Francisco Mejia.
The catcher, Francisco Mejia.
The wind of the pitch. In for a strike. 1-1. Moving in the bullpen, Hansel Robles appears to be getting loose. Brazier warming up as well. The pitch. That misses the zone, and it's a ball and a strike. There's the strike of the knees. Here's a high chopper. Vasquez to first. And that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth.
The seventh fielder, the 35, Brett Hewitt.
Brett Phillips, the next to hit. Flied out his first time. Foul ball. The pitch. Swing and a miss. In the air, out towards right center. Cordero puts the squeeze on that one. Two away now.
The batter number six, second baseman, Taylor Walls.
Taylor Walls will hit next. Fly to left his first time up. First offering, and it just misses. And the 1-0. And that one fouled off. Next pitch is outside. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
From a pitcher's perspective, that's a beautiful splitter right there. As a hitter, you don't like it, but he's commanded his fastball, and out of that same tunnel, that splitter comes, and the bottom just falls out of it.
2-2, just off the outside edge.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And that's ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
So the Rays batting order turns over, and stepping in for the Rays, Yandy Diaz. First pitch, and he just misses.
Now the two out walk. Got to erase that and really go to work on the hitter. You got to go ahead and just let him steal if he's going to try to create the swing and miss and get out of this jam.
Next offering upstairs. And you wonder, is he in his head a little bit?
Even if the base runner doesn't steal right here, what's great is that he is dividing the attention of the pitcher and may serve to give his teammate a better pitch to hit at the plate.
Here's a 3-0. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there. Back when you played, it wasn't the empirical data we have now. It was a guy with a ruler and a diamond taking a colored pencil and drawing a line where he thought someone had hit the ball, right? Runner on the go. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Wander Franco.
Maybe losing command a little bit after the walk. Next pitch, not even close.
The 1-0. And a good eye there.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
Oh, that drilled him. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. 2-3-4 due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Rays 1 and the Red Sox nothing. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the sixth. And now,
leading
Rafael Devers.
For the Red Sox, the third baseman, Rafael Devers.
The wind of the pitch. Slow ground ball to the right side. Takes it himself. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Martinez.
Here is J.D. Martinez. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Bullpen movement for the Rays. Matt Whistler, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Thompson getting cranked up as well. And a pitch.
Hey. Look out, 1-1.
That's hard hit in the line. Phillips pulls it down. And a couple of quick outs.
The batter, number two, shortstop, Xander.
It's Xander Bogaerts now.
Bogaerts.
When you look at Xander, he has all the tools to anchor a World Series lineup.
Yeah, he's one of those rare talents. He's got power at the plate, discipline to go along with it. Oh, and if he gets on, he's got the speed. This guy's a great combo, and he's an RBI machine.
Yoan. On the corner for a strike.
This guy's pounding the zone. Hitters don't have time to think in between pitches.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And that's the third out. Red Sox go down quietly, and it remains 1-0. Now on the bump, Hansel Robles. And he'll do his best to keep this close.
Number 57, Hansel Robles.
Welcome back. New inning getting started. And stepping in for the Rays, G-Man Choi.
The first baseman, G-Man Choi.
The pitch. Good eye right there.
Ball one, no strike.
And it's 1-1. There's the swing and a miss.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle two strikes.
And now 2-2. And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Third time he struck out in this one. And definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead, getting that W.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Randy Arozarena. 1-2. And first offering is fouled off. Inside, just missed. Next offering is downstairs.
When you get to this part of the order, yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
And it's even up.
Well, they just threw that fastball by him, elevated. And if you're not looking up in that location, very difficult to catch up to, especially with that velocity.
And a swing and a miss. Two down.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter, and I'm so glad I'm retired.
Two outs, base is empty. Next is the designated hitter, Harold Ramirez. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Here comes a pitch. Strike two.
Well, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at bat, if he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
Next offering in the dirt, and it's 1-2. And that's downstairs and outside. Two down. Stays alive. Swings here and blasts one left field. That one's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. Rays held in check here. They lead it 1-0.
Traditional seventh inning stretch.
Back here at Fenway, here's the left fielder, Alex Verdugo.
A little surprised we don't see a pinch hitter here. With the lefty-lefty matchup.
Now, Red Sox fans are frustrated, no question. Beeks back to work. 0-1.
Well, this guy on the mound's done a lot better than we would have expected, and the hitters just don't seem to have the right game plan. They're taking too many mistake pitches for called strikes.
Left-hand hitter waits. And that one popped to short. And Verdugo is set down. And there's one away.
The batter, number 10, second baseman, Trevor.
Trevor Story comes up to the plate. First offering misses the mark. Out towards right center field. Low. Settles under it. Makes the grab, and there's two gone.
Now batting, catcher Christian.
And now it's Christian Vasquez. First pitch, not close. Foul ball there. Here's a 1-1.
Ball, that's out.
And a foul ball. Got him. That is the inning. Red Sox go down 1-2-3. Still behind by a count of 1-0. Austin Davis gets the ball now. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Austin Davis.
Back here in Boston, we go to the eighth. Now up for Tampa Bay, Josh Lowe.
Tampa Bay, the right fielder, Josh Lowe.
And a pitch. Just missed. Activity in the bullpen. A right-hander appears to be getting loose. The lefty to 1-0. In the air, out towards left center. And there's one down.
The batter, the catcher, Francisco Mejia.
Here's the catcher to hit, Francisco Mejia. He went deep back in the fourth. A pretty important swing of the bat in this ballgame.
Yeah, bro, he didn't waste any time. He jumped all over that pitch and saw it the entire way. You talk about squaring it up, he didn't miss a stitch on the baseball.
Swing and a line drive, base hit out into center field. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
Right there, does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Brett Phillips.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Brett Phillips. And he pops up the bunt. Dahlbeck makes the grab, and there's two away.
Now batting, the second baseman, Taylor Walls.
Taylor Walls, next to hit for the Rays. A switch hitter batting right. Next offering is down low. 1-0. Bounce to the right. That's a base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Yandy Diaz now. To the right side. Story handles. Gets it to first. Third out. So the Rays strand a pair, but they're on top 1-0. Looks like a pinch hitter for the Red Sox. Kevin Plawecki. Big spot for him here.
Number 25. Kevin Plawecki. Pinch hitting for the Red Sox.
And a pitch.
Kevin.
Off the mark there. Ball one. Kicks and deals. Hard liner. And there's one down.
Now batting, the first baseman, Bobby Dahlbeck.
And next for the Red Sox, Bobby Dahlbeck. 0 for 1 as he reached on an error his first time around. Next pitch downstairs. And that is ball one. Tampa Bay's bullpen with some action. Jason Adam, the anchor of the staff, is getting ready to close this one out. The tying run at the plate. And that one clips the corner. And another ball.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. That one fouled off.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
The 2-2. This to third, and he grabs it. Foul. And delivers outside.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter at this point in the ball game. You know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Looking to get the tying run on base, and the tying run is on base. And the Rays manager making his way towards the mound now as he will make the move. Jalen Beeks won't go any further, and he was a tough nut to crack. Pretty stingy from start to finish. Back with the new arm after a quick break. Now on the mound for the Rays, Colin Pochet. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
Colin Pochet.
Franchi Cordero digs in now.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
First pitch just misses.
Your base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Next offering is in for a strike. One run game, one out, one on. Next pitch is outside. And Pochet ready to work. And that's outside.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, this could be the start of something. They haven't found a way to score yet, but now's their chance to change that.
Now it's Devers at the plate. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
And first offering is fouled off.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
One out. The possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Now one and one. Next pitch is downstairs.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
And here it comes. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Routed to third, could be two. Throw gets by him at second. And he's in safely at third as a run scores on the play, and that ties the game. Substitution now at first base. Pinch running for Boston, Jaron Duran. And now J.D. Martinez. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage with it.
Bounce to the left side. Going 2 now. Swing and a ball popped up to Franco for one, and he'll eat it and be happy with the out.
Now that is shortstop Xander Bogaerts.
Now Xander Bogaerts gets a chance to hit. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Not sure if he was expecting for the pitcher to come right at him, but he got a nice cookie there and just watched it the entire way.
The 0-1. Swing and a foul, pushed off to the right, and that will get out of play. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. The tying run comes across, and we're knotted up again through eight full, all tied 1-1. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Ryan Brazier.
Number 70, Ryan.
Christian Arroyo. Now in the game as he takes over third. Now playing also into the ball game, Rob Refsnyder. He'll be patrolling center field.
Arroyo, now in center field.
All set to start the ninth in this one. Now it's the shortstop, Wander Franco.
Leading off for the Rays, the shortstop, Wander Franco.
And he deals. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Righty to the plate. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Righty delivers. On the ground to short. Bogaerts fields it cleanly. On to first. And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
G-Man Choi next to hit for the Rays. Lifted in the air right center field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down. Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. A strikeout and a walk.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Strike two. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's out number three. 5, 6, and 7 will lead things off in the bottom of the ninth. All tied 1-1. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth. Matt Whistler.
Matt Whistler.
Back here at Fenway Park, all set for the bottom of the ninth. And stepping in for Boston, Alex Verdugo.
The left fielder, Alex.
The pitch. Out to short. Tosses to first. And that is a big first out.
The batter, number 10, second baseman, Trevor.
Here's Trevor Story now.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
First offering misses badly for ball one. Bullpen activity starting up now. Jason Adam, a right-hander with big strikeout stuff, is getting it fired up. Thompson getting loose as well. All tied up here in the last half of inning number nine. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Two of them. Fastball catches the corner at the knees.
Get a little frustrated with the strike zone.
Bounced up the middle. Walls throws to first. And Story is out.
Up next for the Red Sox, the catcher, Christian Vasquez.
Here's Christian Vasquez. In there, and it's 0-1. Next one misses. One ball, one strike. Trying to send this extra innings. Line drive, base hit, leadoff knock, puts the winning run on base.
Well, that may end up being an at bat we go back to later on when this game is over. Solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Now here is Rob Refsnyder. Two outs, but the winning run is at first. And a foul ball left side. Oh and two now. This one in the dirt. Runner holds. Count goes to 1-2. Strike three, got him swinging. Inning over. One left for the Red Sox. Score remains tied, 1-1. And welcome back. On to extra innings. And now the DH, Harold Ramirez.
The designated hitter, Harold.
The right hitter back to work.
Yeah, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
Pickoff throw. Rosarena dives back. Right field, down the line, and that one slices foul. In the air to left center, Verdugo settles underneath it. Makes the grab, one down.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the right fielder.
And now the right fielder, Josh Lowe.
Well, first base open. Really no reason to pitch to this hitter right here. Put him on. Have the force at second, first. Perhaps getting inning-ending double play.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Runner takes off for third. Pitches low. Throw to third, and he's out.
Thought he might have a chance to swipe third successfully right there when he got a good jump from second. But it was such a great throw. Quick tag to cut him down.
Next offering is down low. The 2-1. And that one fouled off. All tied up here in extra innings. Uh-oh, that got him. And the potential winning run is aboard.
Well, that could certainly jumpstart an offense. The hit by pitch right there. And now they have the opportunity to make it really hurt on the scoreboard.
Mejia in the box now. Takes strike one. Next offering upstairs. Next one off the plate inside. 2-1.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
Kicks and fires. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. And that one is lifted in the air. Cordero makes the catch, and that is that. One left for Tampa. Score remains deadlocked at one. We're in extras here. Now, Bobby Dalbec.
Oh, how he'd love to walk it off right here.
The first baseman, Bobby Dalbec.
And a pitch. There's the strike.
Well, a come and get me fastball right there. He didn't look ready for the velocity. I think it'd be a mistake to throw him anything off speed right here.
And 2 as he waves at that one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Number 60 preparing to come on if needed. Oh, and 2 now. Ball one there. Yeah, the 1-2 misses to even the count. And the righty deals. Just misses there.
That's a really good take.
Center field. Phillips gets under it. Puts the squeeze on that one. Runner tagging for third.
The right fielder, number 16.
So the batting order turns over. Now here's the Red Sox leadoff hitter, Franchy Cordero.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring. definitely a strikeout situation right here. Lots of ways for that go-ahead run to score if the ball's put in play.
And now the runner breaks for the plate. It's a squeeze. Across is the winning run, and the Red Sox win it on a walk-off squeeze. Wow!
Well, a gutsy call from the bench. You've got to have a lot of confidence in the ability to handle the bat by that guy standing at the box. Well, he got it done, put the ball on the ground. That's all you're looking for in terms of execution. Incredible finish to this game.
And your final score here today, 2-1. A one-run extra inning win for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
The final run score for this afternoon's ballgame. For the victorious Boston Red Sox, 2 runs on 5 hits. No errors. They left 7 men on base.